Hello and welcome to my top 10 list of the best Boss HM2 clone pedals in the year 2021 that I own. So before we start with the actual list, a couple of disclaimers here. First of all, it's my list, and I don't say that this is the ultimate objective list. It's just my personal taste and my personal experiences with those pedals, so your list might very well differ. Second, since this is the list of the best HM2 clones, I won't include the original Boss HM2, and I won't include the HM2 Wassercraft. So, deal with it. Sorry. I have a dedicated video on the Wassercraft if you want to see what I think about it. Next thing, I already mentioned it, it's a list of the pedals that I actually own or have tried. So, there might be better pedals out there that I haven't tried. And I limit myself to one pedal per brand. Otherwise, the list would be full with four brands and all their different HM2 clones or variations or reiterations, and I don't think that's interesting. During the list, I'll give you a quick example of how I dial in the pedals and how I would use them in a practice context, and therefore I used my Black Hat Custom and the XFX with actually three different amps, and I always used the same Cap IR, which is a Bogren Greasy Beard IR. And now have fun with the actual list. On place number 10, we have the first and only accidental chainsaw in this list, the MXR Full Bore Metal. Accidental chainsaw means that it wasn't supposed to sound like an HM2, but it somehow can. And I put it on the list because it's so versatile. You can put it in front of a clean amp to get a nice distortion. You can put it in front of the power amp to get and work as a preamp. You can boost your driven channel with it. It has an integrated noise gate and it can do the chainsaw. My favorite setting would be highs on zero, mids on full, frack to taste. This is the chainsaw frack, I think, or I found out. Lows a bit reduced to get rid of this flabbiness. Volume full, no scoop, no noise gate, and gain to taste. I typically run it into a more higher driven amp like the Angle Savage, and with a bit more treble. Those amps are trebly, and reduced mids, reduced bass. Here is what it sounds like. Place number 9, we have the Aireon Metal Master. The unique feature about the Metal Master are its two outputs, so you can run two amps in stereo without the need of an additional pedal. That's really cool. And apart from that, it's your typically old clone of the Bose HM2 made in Japan, I think. Yes, this was made in Japan. A typical control layout, and you can also choose if you wanna have a clean output 2 or a affected output 2, so that means both outputs deliver the chainsaw signal. My favorite setting is level on full, bass reduced, because the Metal Master has way more bass than the original. High, full, and distortion to taste into a slightly broken up Marshall-ish amp. This is the Brit JVM OD1 green model. And again, treble increased, mids slightly reduced, bass reduced, and gain reduced. And this is what it sounds like. on place 8 the iMaster because it's so inexpensive. You can get it for way under 40 euros. I think it's around the 20 to 30 euro mark. And you can still purchase it new. The Behringer HM300, I considered it to put it here instead because it has two more control knobs. But let's be honest, we want the full chainsaw. And the Behringer isn't always available new. Plus, it just has a cheap plastic housing, whereas the iMaster has a real solid metal housing. With two knobs, it's really easy to dial it in. Volume always full, gain to around 9 o'clock, my most favorite setting. And again, I prefer to play it into a driven Marshallish amp. On place 6 on this list, we have the modded MT2 by AIB Custom FX. AIB Custom FX is known for his awesome chainsaw mods of different pedals, and basically I could have put every single pedal of him in this list because they are all so good. I just tend to prefer the modded Metal Zone one. So, my favorite setting here is level full, lows to around 3 o'clock, highs, well, 1 o'clock, and the mids have to be this exact position, both at around 9 o'clock, and distortion again to taste. And I like to play it into a slightly more driven amp, again, the Angle Savage. This is what it sounds like. And as some honorable mentions, here the DS1 mod by AIB Customs, or his unique try on the HM2 sound, the Death, or the Hyper Metal modded HM3. You can't go wrong with any of those pedals. The next place would be the Pepas Pedals HM Too Many Clones, and this is on the list because it's a fully custom made HM2 clone for, I think it's still under 100 euros or around the 100 euros mark. And well, you basically get a really good sounding close clone to the HM2, but you also get the options that Tony adds a blend control or a mid control if you want to, and I think that's really cool. Plus it sounds good. I like to play the HM Too Many Clones with slightly reduced lows, but just slightly. I could actually go full, but well, why not? And the distortion a bit more than on the other pedals into again a broken up Marshallish sound. On place 4, my newest addition to the collection, the Electric Eye Audio Swedish Steel, and it's not on the list because of its cool artwork, it's on the list because of the added boost. So if you like your HM2 pedals boosted, you can always use a Tube Screamer or a Boss Super Overdrive in front of them, but since this pedal has an included boost, I think that's really cool and that's why it's on the list. As for my favorite settings, again at around 9 o'clock, the EQ's on full, although treble is slightly reduced because I think it's way too harsh. Not way too harsh, it's a bit too harsh. The boost, of course, activated and tight, and boost around the 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, respectively 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock settings. You have to find out your own sweet spot. And I like to use the Swedish Steel, especially into a PV5150 emulation with increased treble, reduced mids, and, well, bass on full, and slightly reduced gain. And this gives me this sound. On place 4, we have the best close clone to the Boss HM2, the Decibelix Angry Suite in version 2 with an added blend control. Let's be honest here, or let's be subjective, I don't care. This pedal is better than the HM2 Wassercraft. Try to change my mind. Plus, the blend knob is really awesome and it has basically no noise. And it's a mini pedal, so that's cool. My favorite setting is pretty straightforward, everything on max, gain on 9 o'clock. I like to use the blend on this pedal just to slightly introduce more of the amp sound, and because of that I like to play it with a slightly more driven amp, for instance the Angle Savage, or Severe how my model is called. And this is the sound I get. Place 3, the Lichtlamm Audio Breathe Die. This pedal is on the list because of its sheer amount of different options and functionalities. You get a highly tweakable HM2 sound, you get an integrated blend control as well as an expander that kinda works like a noise reducer. We get a phase switch, so you can switch the phase with your blend signal or with the pedal that you put into the FX loop. Plus, we have an added boost. So, it's basically everything you would ever need, if you like the sound. And I think the sound is really cool. My favorite settings are, well, it takes some time to explain, but those are, I don't use the blend control here. The expander I set so that it just reduces a bit of the noise, high to full, mid and shift to 9 o'clock respectively 10 or 11 o'clock, level full, gain around 9 o'clock, and the lows I slightly reduce to 3 o'clock, and I also engage the boost control with the settings basically on noon. And as the Swedish Steel, I like to play this one into a PV5150 emulation. So here is what it sounds like. Some place 2, but I would prefer to call it place 1B, the KMA Audio Machines Guardian of the Wurm. This is the further developed KMA Wurm that made it to last list's second place, but both pedals are equally good. I just prefer to have all the options that are inside the Wurm on top, so I get an easier access to them. But this pedal has a couple more features, for instance, a noise gate and a blend, as well as an FX loop. However, I don't use the FX loop. My favorite setting with this pedal would be master around 2 o'clock, gain again 9 o'clock with the standard clipping. I like to have all the EQ controls on noon, but that highly depends on the amp. If I use it with my PV practice amp, I set them differently to get rid of some noisy frequencies. The EQ style, I actually prefer both EQs, just to be able to shift it this high mid control. Gate is just set that it gets rid of the noise, and I boost the lows and the high mids. High I leave here at noon, and low mids I reduce, and this is the sound. Into an angle amp as well, because I think the Guardian of the Wurm needs a bit more of a high gainy amp, or at least a bit more gain amp sides. And finally, number one, and I don't think that this is a surprise to everyone who watches my channel for some time. It's the same number one that was there 2 years ago, the Lone Wolf Audio Left Hand Wrath Deluxe. Well, what can I say about this pedal that hasn't already been said? I am endorsed by this company for the single reason that I think this is the best sounding HM2 pedal on the market. Joe is capable of highly improving the HM2 circuitry to make it sound better, yet retains all the spirit of the original. And the Deluxe has a couple of options so that you can adjust it to basically any amp you want. It has an added blend control as well. That's really nice. My favorite settings are those two on full. The bass I reduce because it has an increased bass and I don't need as much. The same goes for the presence. I don't need this much presence that the pedal offers. Volume on full, gain again 9 o'clock. Blend for this particular setup, I don't use the blend. However, sometimes I use it. And I've used it actually for some time live with Nightbearer. The frack I leave at noon, although I try to put it up for lead tones, and I would put it down if I would use it with bass. Now, the sub control is the tricky one. It has to be in this exact position. I think it's around 11:30 to get the awesome chainsaw sound with this particular amp that I use. For other amps, you can adjust it, and I think that's a neat option. I also toggle this different clipping option, and I really like to use it with a PV amp simulation, or a real PV amp, but since I'm doing this video with emulations, I chose the 6160 block emulation, and here is what it sounds like. So, that's my list. And now I want to find out what's your favorite HM2 clone, or what's your favorite list. Let me know down in the comment section. Oh, and if you want to support this channel, you might want to check out the links in the description. And with this said, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. May the force be with you, and have a nice day.